Hello and welcome to today's video from the new how-to series. Today we are talking about interfaces, but what does an interface in our LIMS mean? An interface makes it possible to import measurement data from different measurement devices into the LIMS. This is automatically possible with an import in our LIMS. We support a number of different instrument manufacturers such as Bruker, Hitachi, Spectro, Amitec, Thermo Fisher and many more. In this video, I will give an insight into our interface configuration. It will be quickly clear how easy it is to automatically import measurement data into our LIMS. First of all, I will take a look at the import file that we've been given by the measurement device, which we will then automatically import into our database. So now we are into the file. This is a CSV file, XL5. And at first of all, I take a look at the type. This is a UTF-8 file, and this is important for the configuration into the FPLIMS. Then I take a look at the identification fields, the separator between them. At the next one, I take a look at the structure of the date, and I take a look of the elements, when do the elements start, because this is important for the configuration part into the interfaces in our FPLIMS. If I checked all these things, we can step into FPLIMS to see how the configuration looks like, and now we go over there. Now we are in our standard edition from FPLIMS here at the welcome window. We click on configuration of the top of the window, then of interfaces, and you see here a list of available interfaces. They are based at the standard edition in our FPLIMS. Now we click on XL5, go on edit, and if we are here in the setup from our existing interface for the XL5 device. So we see here this is enabled, so they work, and then we see the caption of this one, the file name, the path that we are pick the result file from the device. We have here an interval, you can create the interval what you need. Under this we are also have an instrument manager into our FPLIMS, and you can name the instrument that makes it easier to get an overview about all your different devices. The table name, and here now we find the file type, it's UTF-8. We can select it here, different file types from different measurement devices, and this one is this UTF. So then we see here the decimal separator, we see it into the structure of the CSV file, it is a dot, and after, if we take a look down, we see here the split kind, this is a delimiter, is a comma, and the direct structure of the identification field is a wealth. On the right side, we see here the element, and we take a look at the element structure and at the structure of the same CSV file, and we pick it one-to-one into our FPLIMS to read it in automatically. So now I want to show you how easy it works. We go now back at the welcome window into the analyzers, select here the view of the XL5 and the filter, and we see here the files from the XL5. Now I go to the folder, copy this one. You see, automatically our software picks this file. We go here into the analysis list back, and we have enabled the function auto refresh. And now you see the analysis goes automatically off the top of the analysis list, and you see all analyses that we read in from this file. Finally, I hope that this video can give you an insight into the configuration of our interfaces. That is easy to realize digitalization 4.0. We have over 30 years experience in different industry sectors and support companies worldwide in their daily business. If I have awakened your interest, I am happy to receive a like and a subscriber to our YouTube channel. At the same time, you can discuss your requirements with me in a demo meeting for no charge. You can find the link in the info box. Now, thank you for watching our video. My name is Christoph Kiesendahl, Partner Account Manager at Fink & Partner.